NASA have announced that in 1 week, on July 12th, we are going to be receiving the first ever full-color images from the James Webb Space Telescope. While they haven't announced exactly what the images will be of, I'd like to dive into the information and try make some predictions about what we might see.
Liftoff from a tropical rainforest to the edge of time itself, James Webb begins a voyage back to the birth of the universe. Edge of time itself.
Webb is the largest, most complex observatory that we've ever launched into space, and has been preparing for this moment through 6 months of calibrations. This preparation, combined with years of technological advancements, will be culminating in these first few images to truly showcase what Webb is capable of. The process of deciding what Webb will look at first has been going on for more than 5 years. So what exactly will we see on July 12th? Well, the JWST team have said that it's actually extremely difficult to predict what these images might look like. I mean, this is the highest resolution infrared data that we've ever captured, the likes of which has never been processed before. So we will not really know what it will look like until we see it. However, this won't stop me from making some lighthearted predictions. We've been told that the purpose of these images is to highlight the science themes of the JWST mission. So what are these themes, and how will that translate into images? The first theme is early universe. Webb will sort of act like a time machine, looking back 13.5 billion years to see what the first stars and galaxies looked like while they were being born. Webb is the key to the early universe because of its infrared capabilities. We've never seen this far back before, so it's really anyone's guess as to what it will actually look like. I mean, we still don't even know when the first stars were born, turning on the lights of the universe. Webb will help us solve this problem. The second theme is galaxies over time. Webb will help astronomers compare the faintest, earliest galaxies to the grand spirals and ellipticals that we see today to learn more about how these structures evolve over time. The goal is to understand how matter in the universe organizes itself and how this organization can change over an extremely long period of time. Hubble, JWST's predecessor, captured many beautiful images of spiral galaxies, but they were not born like this. So how did they get to that grand structure that we see today? That is the question that Webb will help solve. The third theme is stellar life cycle. Because Webb is seeing using infrared light, it is able to peer through these big clouds of stellar dust that previous visible light observatories like Hubble were unable to overcome. By looking through this thick dust, Webb hopes to shed light on the breeding ground of baby stars and planetary systems. This famous Hubble image of the pillars of creation show these big pillars of dust that Hubble is simply unable to see through. Webb, on the other hand, will look straight through these pillars to find the first stars and planets forming. These images illustrate this beautifully. So here you can see the pillars of creation taken in the visible light spectrum, but here you can see what the pillars look like in near infrared light. The fourth and final theme of Webb's mission is to explore other worlds. Webb will help us to understand the atmospheres and chemical makeup of exoplanets. And if we are really lucky, we might even find the building blocks for life elsewhere in the universe. We have launched other observatories like Kepler to specifically hunt for these exoplanets, but their imaging and spectroscopic capabilities are far behind Webb's, so that is where Webb comes in. By using Webb's far superior instruments, we are hoping to observe these exoplanets in far greater detail than ever before, to learn more about planetary systems, what the early Earth might have been like, and many other really interesting questions. Taking all of this into account, I'd like to share my personal predictions for what we might see on July 12th. And of course, this list is by no means conclusive. I think there's a good chance that we will see an extremely deep field image, similar to Hubble's ultra deep field, but significantly better. A massive priority of Webb is to look back as far as possible, so I fully expect to see something from 13.5 billion years ago. NASA Administrator Bill Nelson has even said that among the first images from Webb will be the deepest image of our universe that has ever been taken. And some of the astronomers that are working on Webb said that when they first saw this image, it brought them to tears. Secondly, we might see some primordial galaxies very early on in their life cycle, and I expect them to look very different from the galaxies that we see today. I'm also predicting an image that showcases Webb's ability to peer through stellar dust that was previously blocking our view, something like the Pillars of Creation, but from a new mid-infrared perspective. Finally, if we're lucky, we will see some data from exoplanets. Namely, we know that Webb has plans to observe the very famous TRAPPIST system, so fingers crossed. Bonus points for any images of planets or moons from our solar system. Let me leave you with these words from Eric Smith, Webb's program manager. These images will be the culmination of decades of dedication, talent, and dreams. But they will also be just the beginning.